In pretty much every CMS collection I've built, there is always a request to add some kind of filter and search functionality to it, whether it's a blog, a resource library, sometimes even with like people libraries, people always want to be able to search and filter that content. So it's really helpful to know how to add that in, because Webflow doesn't natively have that interactivity built into Webflow. You have to have an extra JavaScript library for it, but luckily there's a really good one that has been built. It is called Attributes by Finsweet. Now, Attributes by Finsweet is awesome because with attributes, all you have to do is add in some attributes to a few items, add in the JavaScript tag, and you're kind of good to go. And those attributes, if you've noticed over here, custom attributes, that's where they go. Nowhere crazy, right there in the settings. So we are going to build this out so that we can filter this blog by these categories here. So I'll show you what that looks like. The first thing we'll need to do is, one, just look at the documentation. So for attributes, they have a bunch of different things. They even have a CMS nest, which we talked about earlier, for adding more nested collection lists. But the thing we're interested in is CMS filter. So if I go to CMS filter, we have a couple really clear steps. The first one is to copy this CMS filter script. So I will copy that first of all, and then come into our page settings and then go all the way to where it says inside head tag and just drop that in. So that's our step one. The next step is to add some attributes to a few different things. So the first thing we'll want to do is a list attribute. So we'll want to add this to the collection list that we are filtering. So that would be our blog list. So I'll click on this, make sure that this one is selected, go into custom attributes. The name is FS CMS filter element, as we found here. And then I'll copy the value and drop the value in as well. So that's sort of our first item of business for the list. The next one is the filters. Now, filters live in a form block. This allows us to put buttons and selects and search fields inside of Webflow. So everything that is filters always goes in a form block. So here in our heading, we had this in a div block. I'm going to hit Command E and type in form block. And by default, we get a little form here. Now I'm just going to delete everything in here for now so that we're just left with the form block. And I want it to go over to the left styling wise. So I'll call this blog header and just put flex. And then instead of left, we'll do space between so that our filters live on the right. Now for our form, you can see that you can do checkboxes, radios, selects, range sliders, inputs. We do a lot of different things here. What I think we'll probably do is checkboxes so that we can select multiple categories at the same time. And there are a few ways we could do that. The first way is just by hitting our form, hitting a Command E, and dropping in a checkbox. But there is a faster way if you want to have some things pre-styled. Here in Finsweet, if you scroll all the way to the bottom, you can get a clonable components UI kit. So that just means Finsweet has already built some pre-built templates for you. So I'm going to start from one of those in the UI kit. So I'll go to not radio buttons, but I'll keep scrolling on down to checkboxes. So you can see you can do ones with images. And I like this one that kind of looks like a button. So I am going to bring that in. With these, you'll notice that there are two in here, and there's a lot of documentation. There are two because one of them has the active class on it, which is Finsweet's way of kind of differentiating what it looks like when it's checked, when it's not. There's some of that you could add in Webflow on its own, but some of it needs a few extra attributes. So yeah, I'm just going to copy this active one, come back into my blog, and just paste it in here, and it got renamed because we've added it in before, but I'm just going to rename it myself to filter checkbox. it already has this isActive class. Don't call this filter checkbox button. And then we'll call this filter checkbox label. Cool. And as we've brought this in, if I go into the settings here and into the settings for label, you can see that it already has a attribute of category and an attribute of is active. So the category we're going to come back to, but active is just giving us a different look for when it's active. In fact, if I take the active class off, you can see that it changes back to its normal state here. I'm going to restyle this a little bit, mainly just bringing this down. And for our isActive class, instead of blue, we'll change it to one of our colors. Maybe this dark red, and this border will also become dark red on active, but I'll remove that for now. Now we need to connect this to our categories. So we could type in every single category, but we could also hit Command E and drop a collection list up here. If I double click and hit source categories, we've got all of the categories here. I can get my button. I'm just going to hit Command X to cut and then paste. Oh, oops. We do have to put the collection list inside the form. There we go. That looks a little bit more normal. And then, oh, I hope I still have it saved. Okay, yes. I just pasted the checkbox in there into our form. And if I click on the label, it doesn't automatically come up with the purple, so I'll hit settings and then change the text to name. Now we have our four categories in here. I don't like that they're all stacked, so I will go into collection list and I'll call this, we'll call this filter wrap, and we'll put flex in here and separate them by 8. So it isn't clear yet that these are a filter, so I'm also going to add in a text block here that says filter by and place it right on top. I'm going to wrap this in a div block, and I already have some classes for margin that are utility classes, so I'm going to hit U, margin, bottom, MB, 1.5, which is a class I've already built, and it's kind of too big. Maybe we can do UMB1. Which isn't built yet, so we'll go ahead and build it now and do 1rem. Now for our blog header, this is looking kind of too spaced out, so I'm going to bring it all to center. That looks good, and now that I look at it, I don't even think we need this margin bottom. And maybe for our filter wrap, we'll just add a little bit of margin on top there. And yeah, maybe just a little bit more. We'll bring it all the way up to 8. Cool. All right. So now we need to go back to our documentation because we've put in the filters. They do live in here. Just the next thing to do is link them all up. So if I go back to our filters, the next thing we need to do is put this attribute on our form or form block. Doesn't matter which one you select. I will go ahead and put it on our form block. The name will be this, and then I'll copy the value, which is filters. And then we can move on to our next step, the field identifier. So we brought in the checkboxes, and what this is saying is the label on whatever checkbox or radio you use has to be the same as a label that lives in the collection list. So if we're filtering by these resources, we need to have something within our collection list that is going to match up so that it can find something to match to. So for us, it's going to be these little category text blocks. And the identifier just needs to have the same name or label or category. So for this one, it was already brought in with this FS CMS filter field category. We're also using category, so I can just do the same thing for this text block. So I'll do this, category. Be sure that it matches up. And that's it. There's a bunch of other stuff we can add too, but I will just go ahead and hit publish and make sure that this is working. Cool. So if I hit news, we can see it goes active and it just filters the news. I can also hit white pages and a few more come up. And this is because it's not sorting by ones that have both, it's just any. So I think we would want it to be just ones that have both. So there's something we can add in there to make it so. So if I go in here and go into match, this will create it so that instead of any, which is the default, it'll be all. So I'll add that to anywhere where filter category is. This also tells you just add it where anywhere the field identifier is. So we'll do all. So now you can see that it really filters down to ones that only have all four. But there is something else. So when you do this on its own and you have pagination enabled, it won't actually filter everything in the list. It'll only filter things on the first page of the list, which is a little bit frustrating. But the way to get around that is Finsweet also has a library for load. And when you use that in conjunction with the filter, everything works. So if I go back to Finsweet and go back to all solutions, I can go to the, this is too low. Yes, CMS load. And this is a really simple script to add in so that Finsweet is also controlling the load. So I'll hit copy, go to our page settings, drop that right below our filter. I'll hit save here. And then if I implement it, the only things I need to do are pick a list and pick a type. So I will add this attribute to our list. This. Come in here. Grab the value. And then the next step is to choose what kind of load. So if you wanted to have a fancier load, you could do render all, load under, infinite scroll. But we're going to keep our pagination and put it on our list as well. Give it a value of pagination. And now I'll hit publish. And now it'll filter through all of them. You can see that the filter resources still stays lit up here. And we get, yeah, all of them filtered down in this use case. Now there's a lot of other filters you can add using Finsweet. If you go back in here and look at the filters, you can also use a search field. So you can add a whole search field where it'll check anything in the blog name. That's one I use pretty often. If you didn't want to be able to check multiple, you could use a radio button using the same kind of principles, or even a select field. Pretty much anything that exists in these form blocks, you can use for filtering too. So we did a lot here. We were able to create a blog collection and import some sample items. We created our blog page with all our individual cards and categories nested inside of there. We also created our blog post template itself using all of those elements from our collection, as well as adding in some conditional elements. And finally, on the live blog, we also know how to add in some filtering to add a little bit extra functionality to our blog. So I hope you're able to follow along. I hope you're able to use this to build a CMS collection of your own. If you have any questions, please reach out, and good luck building your Webflow CMS.
If you found this video useful and want to learn more, be sure to check out our complete guide to Webflow tutorial. It provides comprehensive tutorials and expert guidance to help you build professional-grade websites, and also has courses on other no-code tools. And if you haven't done so already, or if you're new here, subscribe to the channel for more content like this, share it with a friend, and if you have any questions, leave a comment below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.